8-year-old Jarrell McGee loves to play outside, especially his favorite sport.
Basketball.
But yesterday, the toddler's time outside ended with a trip to the hospital after he touched this, a live wire in front of his family's home.
And when he touched the wire, he couldn't get it loose. He went to shaking.
I ran over here. I tried to shake him off. I couldn't get him off. He was hollering, get me off, help me.
His father, Willie, was able to rescue Jarrell, but was also shocked in the process.
I took his hands loose. His hands were smoking, literally had fire in his hands, so I had to take my hands and smack the fire out of his hands. Then they were smoking, and he just was hollering, Daddy, it hurts, it hurts.
The boy was rushed to Ochsner Hospital, where he was treated for electrocution and third-degree burns on his hands and fingers.
They keep on hurting.
Jarrell is now afraid to go near the light pole. The family says they've complained about this exposed wire for years. The grandfather even covered it with electrical tape.
If he didn't cover that wire with that black tape, my child wouldn't be here today.
We checked with Entergy, and a spokesperson tells us they're not responsible for the maintenance of the light poles. That's a city job.
The city gets no response when you do call.
They didn't even come out here to check this. This naked wire out here, it could have been some other kid, or it could have been his life.
When we checked with the city, they told us many of the covers were gone because of theft, but they are working to fix things, adding more money to the budget for repairs. They sent a statement that reads in part, quote, currently the city has 6 crews working 13 hours per day, 6 days per week, which has significantly increased inspections and routine repairs.
I mean, all you got to do is put a little plate over it or something where the kids, now how you going to tell a 3 or 4 year old not to, they're curious.
And so are we. We looked at other light poles on the same street and the next block and found at least 10 more uncovered with wires exposed. One was even taped up. Here's what the light pole looks like with the panel intact. After our phone calls, an electrical worker came and repaired the light pole, a sight that was overwhelming for this family, who's still counting their blessings that little Jarrell's injuries weren't worse.